EA Games.
Challenge everything.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Before I get started with this video, there's a couple of things I'd just like to say quickly. Firstly, I've recently bought a new microphone, and I've been fiddling around with the settings in OBS, but I don't really know what I'm doing, to be honest, and I feel like the quality still isn't there. I did follow like some YouTube videos that talked about audio settings and stuff in OBS, but I just, like, fiddling around, copying the settings they used, nothing really sounded right to me. So, if the audio in this video isn't great, I apologize for that. Also, I've recently surpassed 2,000 subscribers, so I'd just like to really thank everybody who has been subscribing and commenting on my videos. Before I started making videos on this channel, So I think I may have talked about this before in a previous video, but I initially made this channel actually in 2013, and at the time I had the intention of making Elder Scrolls content, and I'd still like to at some point, but I haven't gotten around to it yet. But anyway, so I didn't make any videos in the end, because I guess I didn't feel confident enough to do it back then. It just wasn't the right time, I guess. I'm still quite anxious talking on mic, but back then especially, I guess it just really wasn't the time, so I didn't make any content back then. So fast forward to like 2020, like several years in the future, with no videos, and my analytics page looks hilarious, by the way, because there's this long massive gap of nothing, and then like you have all of the like spikes of views and stuff from the last year. So yeah, and then in March 2020, I randomly just woke up, like literally just woke up one day like, you know what, I want to play The Sims 2 again, because I hadn't played it since probably 2009. But before I made that video, the first video on my channel where you can see the messed up pets for the first time, I actually, like maybe a month or so before, I'd been thinking about making videos for a little while before that, but I had this dream where I specifically had a gaming channel with 2,000 subscribers, which is why like this number is like kind of a big deal for me, because it's kind of ridiculous, but I actually had a dream, like a literal dream, where I had this gaming channel with 2,000 subscribers. And so when I first started uploading videos, I kind of kept that dream in mind, because I didn't necessarily think I'd ever get there, but it was sort of like a kind of mental target. So yeah, thank you to everyone who has subscribed to my channel. Okay, so with that all being said, I'm now gonna start playing the actual game, The Sims on console. I have not played this game since longer than the gap in between not playing The Sims 2 and playing The Sims 2 again. It's been like since I was probably 11 or 12 or something like that, and I'm like 30 now, so it's been approximately 2 decades since I played this game. Okay, so I had numerous problems with this yesterday. The version of the game that I had kept freezing with the emulator I'm using. I basically decided to scrap my previous playthrough because I was quite tired by the time I'd gotten it all working, and I wasn't really happy with it. So this is basically take two. So I have actually played a little bit of this already, up to like the beginning of the mum's house level. So I'm just gonna recreate my character now, basically. I decided to call them Merrick, because I typed in, like, random vampire name, I think. I don't know. I decided to go with a goth vibe with this one because their surname's goth, like they're a long lost goth relative. I had no idea what. I realised when I loaded the game, I had no character in mind at all for this. I just wanted to play The Sims 1, so I just kind of made it up on the spot. Oh yes, before I move on, I just wanted to show you how many skin tone options you have in The Sims 1 console game. Compared to The Sims 2, The Sims 2 has 4 skin tone options unless you use custom content. You also have like all these color options for like everything, but I will say that the clothing options in this game are terrible, and like there's, for some reason, this is just everyday clothes. You can't set pajamas or anything, but half of them are just underwear for some reason. And this burglar guy keeps coming by as well, which is, it's a much more interactive creator sim. I noticed a couple of times it actually froze when the burglar came, so I'm hoping that doesn't happen again. But it's just like, I can't process it. No, I'm getting robbed. Crashed the entire game. Yeah, I gave him like bright green. It looks kind of pixelated, these sandals, actually. They have like a, I don't know if it's supposed to look like that, but there are like a bunch of red bits. I feel like it's not supposed to look like that, and that's just because of the texture resolution or something like that. You don't get infinite colors with the hair like you do the clothes, which is slightly disappointing because I was thinking of giving him like bright purple hair to match the purple thing, but yeah. This is kind of blue tinted though, I mean. Oh, and I gave him purple eyes, because you do actually have like quite a range of eye colours as well. But to be fair, there's no genetics in this game really, so you can have in the neighbourhood, I don't know if you can have kids in this version, you can definitely have it in the free play version that came with this game. But like, the kids don't grow up obviously, just like in The Sims 1 for PC. And I don't think I don't think there's genetics either. I don't think, like, I think if they do end up looking like the parents, it's more of a coincidence. So I gave him these earrings, but I just want to show you something quickly again, because they have these glasses, which are just, I feel like they changed the eye shape, but maybe they don't. Maybe it's just the way the glasses are, but yeah, I guess they're supposed to be like Harry Potter glasses. I don't know. I think this is more or less what I went with. I don't know if I actually, yeah, because I had like bright neon green. I think that might have been the shade. Have to get the perfect shade of neon green sandals. But seriously, the clothing in this game is terrible. Yeah, this is so weird. Like, it's very dated now as well. And there's lots of, like, I'm just gonna point out some of the more interesting things I noticed and remembered. Yeah, so you're in a dream when you get into this level. Whenever you kiss in this game, it has, like, really dramatic music every single time. I think it happens, I don't know if it happens every time, but and it might do, actually. It might happen every time, I don't really remember. Yeah, so the TVs in this game just have, like, animated GIFs, basically, which is great. I'm gonna, like, switch it to horror quickly. Yeah, it's not scary. Oh yeah, and there's this version of the love bed. It's very dark, like, because there's no, you can't ever see the sky. And things are still somewhat limited, like the camera, but compared to The Sims 1, it's interesting because The Sims 1 obviously was isometric and 2D, except for The Sims themselves. I don't know if she'll get angry and then rage quit, I can't remember. She might do, and then you fail the very first level. I can't remember because it's been so long. I didn't fail it last time I did it, so I'm tempted to wait and see what happens. Oh yeah! And there's this like cooler as well. You can sit on it and get drinks. Oh, I missed that cooler. That was cool. I think there's something similar actually in The Sims 4 that came with the what pack is it? There's a pack, I don't actually own it, but I'm pretty sure it came with a cooler. It's like a wow, I do not pay attention to The Sims 4. I also kept calling there's a pack in it that I keep calling Glamour Life stuff because I get it mixed up with the Sims 2 expansion. Yeah, so the shower. It's like it's like not a proper shower, it's like some kind of sci-fi thing. Oh man, what is it called though? The pack I'm thinking of. I don't know why I've forgotten the name either, because I know Into the Woods. It's like it's like Three Lakes from The Sims 2. Yeah, okay, Roxy. We're busy with the icebox right now. Oh, I don't remember the freezing animation. Why would you be getting so cold though? I mean, it's not that cold. You can sit down on it as well. I feel like at 12 something will happen. No? Okay. She's getting really grumpy. Like, maybe... Oh, there's a train set as well. Yeah, that came back in The Sims 2. I don't actually know which of these items are in The Sims 1 on PC, to be honest, because I only played it very, very briefly. So I don't know if, like, and I only had the Make Your Magic expansion as well. Yeah, the game pack I'm thinking of is called Outdoor Retreat. I don't know why I couldn't remember that. It's just... Damn it, Merrick, get in here with me. She just gets grumpier and grumpier, I think. I don't know if there's a point where she just stops, and now that I've kind of committed to it, I feel like I'm gonna... Can we ask her to join? Roxy. No, wait, what? Will that make her join? She's not playing pool. You know, something else I'm kind of interested by is the possibility of modding stuff like this. Well, because people do that. They make, like, ROM hacks of different games. And that would be interesting and potentially amusing. I have no idea if something like that exists for this. You never join me in the hot tub. I'm getting out of here. Game over. Yeah, I knew there was a point where she gets so angry she just quits. This is not a good message. Yeah, it's not great. Oh, do I actually have to start again? Oh no, I just made the character again. Okay, so we're back in the mansion. I really feel like what they should have done is just have it, since this is meant to be a dream, you should just wake up whether you go in the hot tub or not. But they really forced the hot tub idea. And yeah, and like, if you make a female sim, they have like a male sim in the hot tub as well, instead of Roxy, but I forgot what his name is. Also, she stole Belagoff's dress. So we're just gonna get straight in this time, since I've already failed this once. Oh yeah, you get woken up by your mum as well. Because you're dreaming. Yeah, the sound effects of this are great. Oh Oh great, now how are we supposed to have any fun around here? I'm missing my soap operas. Can you actually watch soap operas though? I don't know that you can. Oh yeah, you can control mom now too. And one thing, like one weird thing, you can make her repair the TV, but I think she gets electrocuted every single time. Yeah. That sound is terrifying, honestly. Like, compared to the sound effects in later game, it's really intense. It reminds me of like Tomb Raider when she dies in the early games, and you can like the sound effects. Like she breaks like every bone in her body or something. It's like a lot more intense than the sound effects these days. Yeah, she says the message just left because I was talking. The message just disappeared because I was talking too much. But she says something like, "Oh my God, you made an old lady repair a TV." But it's funny because in The Sims 2, all of the repair people are like elderly, so they're all elders. Yeah, so we have to. There's a list of goals that we have to complete the mom level. So we need to borrow 800 dot not dollars, 800 simoleons from mom. And then cook dinner without starting a fire and fix the TV. So we have to get out both mechanical and cooking points. This game actually doesn't have cleaning. I think probably The Sims 1 didn't either, because I think most of the skill points are based on that. Yeah, she just randomly rants at you. Also, you can't get a job, and she actually points that out. Like, if you try and get a job, what are you doing? You can't look for a job now, you don't have enough skills yet. Which is not a thing in The Sims 2. It's a lot easier to get a job in The Sims 2. I feel like this sound is kind of low, I'm gonna turn it up a bit. Master Chef in the making. Well, we're kind of way off that. Also, there's no food in this game. Like, there are no food options. You just have the option to, like, serve lunch, dinner, and breakfast. And all of the food, I think, looks the same. And it's always the same ambiguous looking food that you can't really discern what it's supposed to be. You'll see in a minute. And, you can't have bubble baths, which is, like, terrible, really. Also, while they read, they make this kind of noise, like I'm just gonna look through the buy mode catalog quickly. Actually, we need to get him a bed anyway, but I don't know if he can afford one yet. Yeah, there's way less objects, I think, in this though, to be honest. This is cool though. Like, there's a bunch of kid stuff. Also, this telescope. I can't remember if you can get abducted in this game. I'm leaning towards no, because I really don't remember that, but yeah. It has the Sims 1 soundtrack as well, which is the best soundtrack. This one's like really sad now. But I was listening to this on YouTube recently, and there was a YouTube comment that was like, this sounds really sad now, like compared to how it used to sound, which is true. I don't want to die. I'm actually gonna save because is that saving? There we go. I'm missing my soap operas. Oh my god, Mom! Mechanical building takes time! You know what? You study mechanical! No way, other Sims in this household should study mechanical things. See, they know what I'm doing. They know. The game knows. It's not having it. Okay. All right. Fine. What can you do then? Can she study cooking? All right. God. She actually has 4 cooking points already. So those are the only things you can do.
Mm.
I think she's hungry. She's the same hand animations as like an old PlayStation games. Like, it reminds me of the Rugrats. There's this one scene where they're like trying to eat one of the characters, the grandpa in the Rugrats game. He's trying to eat some potato salad, and he moves his hand, and it's like, because the fingers don't move, and it's that same kind of flat 2D look that they have in old games. But it's not 2D, but it kind of looks that way. Oh my god, that sound though. They just do it over and over again. Yeah, we've got rap, country, bluegrass, and whatever this is. I swear this music is really familiar to me, but what else is it in? Oh yeah, it's the rock station. You look as bored as I feel. Stop! We'll fix the TV eventually. Also, I feel like there are more service sims that are introduced later in the game, but I can't fully remember. But at the moment, all you have is pizza, gardeners, fire, department, and police, and you can't get a maid yet. Which I suppose makes sense, because it's like too early in the game. I think, yeah. The animations in this are very robotic. I feel like, I don't know where they got this music from, because in later games they like invite artists to come to record simlish versions of their songs, but I don't know where any of these, like none of these are recognizable to me. I feel like they were all designed specifically for The Sims. Oh yeah, that happens when it switches from day to night. God, this is not boosting up quickly, is it? I'm gonna try fixing the TV now, but I have a feeling that's gonna go badly. She needs to go to the loo too. I turned Free Will off, I think. Oh my god, just constantly complaining. Ouch. I like how his sandals are the same color as the bar. You know, the bar is just completely full, so I don't know what's happening here. It's just not working. It's still taking... It's like when you install something and it gets to like 99% and then it just hangs on that final percent. Okay, so I think the TV's working now. Yeah, it has this little music. Charis Master Vanity Mirror. That's pretty cool. Like, for the first level, you get this cool mirror thing. You also get the aromatherapy thing if you complete another one of the tasks in this level. And that was in the mansion, which just makes it seem a lot less cool. Oh yeah, I think like different TVs have different things as well. This isn't even an animated like GIF or whatever. It's literally just a still image. What happens if, like, what do the others look like? I just need to check quickly. Yeah, that's just a photo, and they're not Sims. I can tell they're real people, so... One annoying thing is I don't think there's a way to cancel stuff further back in the queue. If you stack it in, like, the Sims action queue, you can only cancel the last thing they did, which is annoying. There's cartoons as well. I don't know what soap opera she was talking about, but this is not... I don't think we get it on this TV. That is not a cartoon! What kind of cartoon is that? I can't even tell what that is. It looks like a photo of a building in grayscale. It could be, there could be a sofa there with a guy sat on it. Like someone sat down on the sofa. You can't zoom in any more than this. I have no idea. Aside from the sound effects, which are obviously like cartoon sound effects, there's just no way of knowing. The lighting in this game, though, it's claustrophobic. That's how I'd maybe describe it. Okay, so we have to serve dinner as well. Stop watching the still image! Sims must have been so bored in Sims 1. No wonder they're starting fires all the time. They need something to do. I'm gonna have her kick it, because that seems to fit her personality. She can kick the flamingos. But I think it maybe breaks it or something. Like, sometimes. Yeah, you unlock the Aroma Master Whipperpuff thing, which was something that was in the mansion, and it just makes it seem like less cool now. That poor. I like how it squeaks when you kick it as well. I wonder if she can water the plants or if she's gonna like be like no. Oh, okay. So she won't repair or cook, but she will water plants. Yeah, so that's the mysterious looking food. I don't entirely know what it is. Like, maybe it's some kind of pasta thing, but then when do they pick it up? It's even more ambiguous. It just looks like a. It's impossible to know what that food is supposed to be. Oh god, look at that thought bubble. That's so. I say the same things a lot in this game. Also, like, the sound of the Simlish is very different sounding. I feel like it almost sounds like an entirely different language. Like, I like to pretend that these Sims are speaking like a different Simlish, like they're from a different Sim country to the other Sims, because the other Sim games always like the difference between the sound of the Simlish, even though it's mostly like completely fabricated and doesn't have any much of any internal logic to it. It sounds a lot more similar between the other games, like it's less distinctive. What's the difference between entertain and joke, I wonder? Oh, really? So you just juggle, okay. Oh, they're actually friends now. Maybe we can use the tickle one. I feel like the social interactions are a bit quicker in this game. Maybe we can borrow money from her now. Oh, what? Oh, no. I didn't realize we had to do it incrementally. So how much do you get each time? Like 100? I feel like she's gonna get grumpy if we do it too many times. Let's give her a hug in between at least. Give back, Rob. Now that's just weird to me because in the later Sims games, that's only a romantic interaction, even though it doesn't really make sense for it to be, but yeah. Oh no. I'm not in the mood to lend you any money. Does she need to be in a better mood? Let's make her watch some horror soaps. Sit down and eat, watch the soaps. Okay. I'm gonna feed the fish. I don't know if it's possible for the. Oh, maybe they can die in this game, I don't know. They all came up to eat the fish. I mean, they all came up to eat the fish? They all came up to eat the food. Yeah, it's that music again. I swear I've heard this in some other game. Oh right, I think it's in Bustin' Out as well. You can't hear it very loud right now because the TV's over. Why don't you take it? Why does she sound grumpy when she's like just saying to take a nap and like out of concern? Like her only voice is like grumpy. Okay, she needs to go to bed too. We'll just turn everything off.
No, 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 no.
think she's gonna fall asleep soon. You can't have leftovers in this game. I'm gonna make him eat more food though. I don't think they fall asleep eating in this game either. Yeah, their pajamas are like just randomly generated. He spent a considerable time there just eating nothing on the plate, because the plate was like graphically empty, but he just kept eating anyway. Oh, so you do still get the triple speed while they're sleeping, but and in later games I think they just went on to like quadruple speed for sleeping, maybe? In Sims 4, I think. Surely you have like an even faster speed in that game. Kind of wondering if it's based on their shoes now, because it looks like his pajamas are green. Oh yeah! The paper, like, kid, always... You can't talk to them. They have like a little tune they hum, well, whistle. And that's repetitive too, it just goes on and on until they leave the lot. Oh, even these plotted plants need watering. That's interesting. Does this need watering too? It does! That's interesting, because they don't in later games. Oh, mum's awake. She's still in her pajamas. I guess that happens until you change out of, like, into different clothes or have a bath. I feel like he's not messy enough to, like, do that. But okay. I mean, he has 4 points. I don't think she likes this channel. What about this channel? Doesn't sound like she likes it either. I don't know if there's any channel that... Is she enjoying that more? She's just making lots of disgruntled noises, but I think she did that for every channel. Okay, sit down. Okay, I think these are just the sound effects. She doesn't sound like she's enjoying it, but it seems to be that way for every single channel. You can't select more than once, like at a time. Okay. Oh, she needs to eat first. What's the difference between quick dinner? Let's look in the fridge. Can't really zoom in. Okay. That seems more like how quick is it? It still uses the oven. What is the... I really don't see the difference, honestly. Isn't it even... Let's see what the difference is. Is it just that it just skips out... All it does, I think, is remove the processor part. But you still have to use the oven. I don't know if this game has microwaves. I didn't notice that. Oh no! Oh, he's gonna wake up because of the TV anyway. I don't think she's gonna do it because now she's like grumpy from the TV. Yeah. Okay. I mean, her low fun motive, not the TV. This isn't gonna work out. Okay. I guess we'll have to make her read a book. That builds so slowly. I'm just gonna send her to bed too. It really incentivizes syncing Sims' sleeping patterns, because otherwise you do not, like, it moves way too slow. I feel like he's gonna get woken up before he's fully fully slept again. Oh no. I bet that's a prank call. Like, what's the... used to get, like, prank calls in Sims, so... Look at the animations. You're a winter and should decorate accordingly if you want to live most harmoniously in your house. Oh my god. I don't think there's any way to make phones silent either. You can move them to a different room though, I guess. Are you writing a disgusting science project? Okay, let's see if this works. Oh no, she's still not in the best mood. So close. Okay, there's no way this is gonna work. Does that, like, I don't think that really depletes her relationship. Okay, I think this might work now. Yeah! Now you can visit the museum too, to play a game. I didn't realise it said multiplayer. I can't remember that. I never used the multiplayer in any of these games anyway. Like, I know Buster Now had multiplayer, but I never had, like, the ability to hook my PS2 up online. Yeah. We're gonna move out, though. And then move on to the next one. I don't actually remember what the next level is, either. Also, I don't know, like, huh. I feel like it will, where you go next may depend on this, but I don't remember this game at all. Like, the rules of this game. I remember Mom's house, but I don't remember most of the levels. I have, like, vague memories of stuff. So, I know in Busted Out, certain decisions you make influence where you move. Like, you can move to Mimi's or Dudley's house, but this is a little different. I'm gonna go with musician career, I think. A car will be sent at 2 p.m. Merrick finally got a job. The Perspiration Executive Treadmill. Is there another treadmill? Or I feel like that's the only treadmill. It's just something that's, like, unlocked in other games anyway.
Go to Mr. Landgrab's house up the street and give him the rental deposit I lent you. He's got a place that's just perfect for you. Mum owes Merrick 702 simoleons. I wonder if that amount changes depending on what you do. I don't know. I don't think there's any, like, oh, I should have sold some stuff before moving. So I don't know if you get to keep all of the simoleons.
Okay, well, I'm gonna end this video here. Thank you for watching the first episode of my Sims console Let's Play, and I'll see you guys in the next video.